Hello all, welcome to the video lecture on genetic engineering of plants. In this particular lecture, we will be trying to understand what is plant transformation, plant transgenesis, and why plants are suitable for genetic engineering. We will also discuss the limitations of the conventional methods and what is the impact of plant biotechnology and various methods of transferring genes to plants, and also we will discuss related techniques such as protoplast fusion. There are many conventional methods which are used in plant improvement. There are certain limitations. Methods of crossbreeding are slow and uncertain. We also have the problems of polyploidy. Biotechnology promises to circumvent these limitations. Recombinant DNA technology is an important tool which is extensively being used in generation of transgenic plants. There is a need for us to understand effective DNA delivery system and expression vectors for successful transgenic plants. Plants have certain advantages which make them suitable for genetic engineering. Plant cells are totipotent, meaning entire plant can be generated from a single cell. Fertile transgenic plants can be produced from genetic engineered cells. And if the transgenic plants flowers and produce a viable seeds, the desired trait introduced through the plant genetic engineering can be passed on to the successive generation. Plants have better regenerative capacity than animals. A variety of strains are available from the conventional plant breeding. Plants produce a large number of progeny, and rare mutations and recombination can be found easily. Species boundaries and compatibility are not an issue with the advances in the molecular biology techniques for improvement of plants. Genetically determined traits can be introduced as either a single gene or a cluster of genes. Addition of selected desirable genes often improves the agricultural, horticultural, and ornamental value of a crop plant or a medicinal plant. They can act as an inexpensive production of various economically important secondary metabolites, including proteins. They provide a powerful means of studying the action of genes during the development and other biological process. Why do we need transgenic plants? Addition of genes often improves the agricultural, horticultural, and ornamental value of many crop plants and medicinal plants. They can act as an inexpensive production of economically important secondary metabolites, phytochemicals, biopigments, and other proteins. They provide a powerful means for studying the action of genes during the development and other biological process. Let us look into the practical applications of transgenic plants. Transferring genes to plants through transgenic technology allows us a variety of innovations that were not possible by the conventional breeding. We can develop plants that produce their own pesticides. Thereby, we can develop insect-resistant plants, plants that are resistant to herbicides and viruses, as is the case of example of papaya virus, plants that produce biopharmaceuticals, plants that can tolerate the environmental stress and higher salt concentration. We are all aware that the limitations of growing agricultural crops along the coastal areas wherein the salt concentrations are high. So plants which are able to tolerate this high salt concentration, a rice variety, a wheat variety, can be developed so that we can the productivity and utility of high salt concentration lands can be made use of. We can develop plants that produce vaccines. We call as plant bodies. We can develop plants that produce strong fibers. We can improve the strength of the jute. We can improve the strength of the cotton and other fiber producing plants. We can develop plants that can produce enhanced nutrition, plants that produce novel secondary metabolites, and these transgenic plants may be of great use to the pharmaceuticals as well as in the development of biofuels in future. These are the some of the examples of the transgenic plants which already have been developed. We have transgenic tomatoes, potatoes, lettuce, cotton, soybean, and wide variety of transgenic peas plant, carrot, cabbage, and many of the commercial crops such as sugar beet, eggplant, and thus plant biotechnology will not only have an enormous impact on the traditional plant breeding but also can be used to create new plants. Conventionally, tomatoes have a limited durability time. However, researchers have found a new technique to increase the durability of tomatoes, and this technique was developed at National Institute of Plant Genomic Research. So with this new transgenic technique created, tomatoes can be preserved for more than 1.5 months of plucking without being squeezy, thus making it an advantage for many such commercial crops for improvement in their stability. Here is another example of transgenic plants. The tomato flavor has been improved by the terpenoid pathway. With the advances of the molecular biology, genes that are involved in the terpenoid pathway have been transferred to the tomatoes to enhance the flavor and thereby enhance the marketability of the product. Similar innovations are possible for a wide variety of vegetables, medicinal plants, and other commercially important plants. This is a representative of transgenic potato. Scientists have created a transgenic BT brinjal by inserting a gene Cry1AC from soil bacterium Bacillus thuringiensis into the brinjal plant. Insertion of this particular gene into young cotyledons through the agrobacterium mediated vector allows the gene expression along with the promoters and markers, and is said to give the brinjal plant resistant against a wide variety of Leptidopteran insects like brinjal fruit and shoot borer. This was developed by the company called Myco, Maharashtra Hybrid Seeds Company. Similarly, many variety of vegetables and medicinal plants, transgenic plants, were developed using the transgenic technology. Here is a representative picture of transgenic corns. Clearly depicts the advantage of transgenic plants over the conventional plants. What we see is a transgenic cotton plant. Many insects infect the cotton plant at a very early stage, thereby reducing the productivity. With the advances in transgenic cotton, the plants are able to develop toxins against the insects, and thereby the productivity of the cotton is improved through transgenic cotton. Conventionally, cauliflower is white in color. However, the nutritional qualities of grapes and other plants have been associated with the anthocyanins and other important coloring matter is well known. Transgenic technology, it is now possible to transfer the relevant genes and make cauliflower enriched with the nutrients and with different colors with increased marketability for. In other words, genetic engineering can help us transfer selected genes and selected traits into the plants, whether be it a vegetable plant, be it a medicinal plant, so as to improve the variety and address many underlying problems. Here is a very classical example of applications of transgenic technology to rice. Scientists have developed a transgenic rice wherein here is a very unique and interesting application of transgenic technology. International Rice Research Institute, Manila, Philippines have developed a transgenic rice which can express beta carotene. We call it as golden rice. The genes that are involved in the beta carotene formation are introduced into the rice plant through the agrobacterium mediated transgenic method, wherein the rice variety developed will express the beta carotene genes, and therefore they are golden in color and are known as golden rice. As we all know, many of the Southeast Asian countries are suffering from the night blindness. Consumption of this golden rice will reduce their night blindness. With this intention, this particular transgenic application oriented transgenic rice have been developed. Depicts the enormous potential of the transgenic technology in developing wide variety of cereals, transgenic cereals, as well as vegetables, as well as medicinal plants, commercially important commercial plants such as cotton, brinjal, and a variety of plants. Let us look it into another interesting application of transgenic technology. A team of scientists from Pennsylvania State University have identified a gene that controls the size and weight of the rice genes. So through transgenic technology, this gene may be transferred into the conventional rice varieties to develop high yield rice, and which is of great use to people who rely upon rice as a staple food. Similarly, many scientists have proven the enormous beneficial applications of the transgenic technology for improvement of wide variety of plants. Conventional papayas are prone to wide varieties of viruses, and there is a premature truncation of the fruits from the plants because of these wide variety of viral infections, as seen in the picture. A transgenic papaya plants have been developed, and this is the basis of economy for many of the countries like Taiwan and other Southeast Asian countries, improving their economy. We have yet another application of transgenic plants to floriculture. A variety of phenotypic expression of genes of different commercially important flowers have been attempted by various scientists. Transgenic floral plants which are commercially viable have been developed by the scientists. Representative picture of transgenic floral plants. These are the some of the additional references of golden rice and other transgenic plants applications which are of use in understanding transgenic technology. Technology will not only have an enormous impact on traditional plant breeding, but is also very useful in creating new plants. A variety of beneficial transgenic cereal plants, ornamental plants, nutraceutical, transgenic, commercial and medicinal plants using different